Now I want to talk about the H matrix. And this is a matrix that takes a state, and when it multiplies with that state, spits out a measurement. And remember, we can only directly measure position and velocity, so that's all we want the H matrix to keep. So again, I want to talk about the 2D lecture case and the 4D homework case. And hopefully, by comparing them, we'll be able to build some intuition and you'll be able to answer the homework. Okay, so what was the goal of the H matrix? The goal of the H matrix was to take some state, and in the 2D case, our state was represented as an X and an X dot, multiply some matrix by that state in such a way that we extract a measurement. And in the 2D case, the measurement was just X, just the X coordinate. So we can think of this as a 1x1 vector or 1x1 matrix. And the matrix we used to do that was this one. That was our H matrix. 1, 0. Because 1 times x gives us the x, 0 times x dot gives us nothing, exactly what we want. But now, let's talk about the dimensionality of these matrices and how this multiplication yielded just this number x. So, well, x here we can think of as a 1x1 matrix. And we got that matrix by multiplying this one, which is a 1x2, one row by two columns, with this, which is two rows by one column. And what we see here is that this one actually came from right here. And this one came from right here. And these twos we can think of as canceling out in a way, giving us this 1x1 matrix. Now let's see if we can generalize that to the four-dimensional case as presented in the homework. Well, in the four-dimensional case, our state is now given by x, y, x dot, y dot. We're going to have some H matrix. I don't know anything about it yet, but I'm just going to put this there for now as a placeholder. And we want to get a measurement from that. And what should this measurement be? It's not just going to be x, because now our position includes both x and y. So it's going to be a column vector, x and y. Okay, so again, let's think. What's going on with the dimensionality here? Here we have a 2x1 matrix. And that came from this matrix, which I said we don't know anything about yet. So I'll just say question mark by question mark. And this matrix, which is four rows by one column. Now, can you use the intuition we built up here for how the dimensionality of matrices works with this to fill in the question marks? I think once you figure out the number of rows and the number of columns in this H matrix, figuring out where to put your ones and zeros will be a little bit easier. I wish you luck.